Welcome to the Tennis Warehouse Racquet Review of the Yonex VCORE Duel G 97330. Endorsed by multiple Grand Slam champion Stan Wawrinka for the 2016 season, this heavy version of the Duel G 97 offers loads of heft and feel for experienced players. Tough G fiber technology has been added to the throat of the frame to increase stiffness, while the signature isometric head shape enlarges the sweet spot for more comfort and forgiveness. First up, we've got the one and only Troy Lara, who's even got his Stan the Man Stick It Wear shirt here for this review. I know you're a fan of that heavier, more traditional style player's frame. How did this one work out for you?
Yeah, I mean, the specs of this racket are pretty much identical to what I've played with over the years. From the Yonex line, if I had to pick a racket stock form, this would definitely be the racket I could switch to. There's a lot of things about this racket that play similar to the 6-1 that I've used for quite some years now. I love the control. I felt like the Tour G, the previous version of this racket, was great for control, but as we talked about, I felt like the older model was a little muted, lacked a little bit of response, even though I felt like I could place the ball well. This one just comes in a little crisper, a little bit more feedback. I felt great from the baseline. I liked it at the net. The specs on one of the hitters that I tested, it had a little higher swing weight, almost like 340. So that was a little unwieldy at times at net and maybe on like the kick serve and stuff like that. So spec-wise, if I could find one, lower 330s, a little bit closer to my spec, definitely like this racket. My favorite shot with this was a two-handed backhand. I just felt like I could plow through the ball, drive it down the line, cross court. It was just silky smooth. But I love the update of the cosmetic with a little more black than orange, just my preference. But leather grip, like Stan the Man said it on the last review, this is a great stick.
Next up, we've got Michelle. Like Troy, you kind of gravitate towards those heavier rackets. How did this one work out for you?
Yeah, I was super stoked when I got put on this play test, because anytime a racket that comes in with a heavier weight and a beefy swing weight, I'm really excited to try it. And this racket was amazing. I had so much fun hitting with it. I couldn't get it out of my hands. I had some impressive play sight numbers off my forehands. I was hitting in the mid 80s consistently, like really big forehands. And I had that control, which is what my game needs. So I was easily getting some power out of this racket, but I didn't feel like I was missing a lot. So love that. On serve, I was bombing some great serves. As you know, I've been working a lot on trying to get my serves going, and this racket really allowed me to tap into that extra power. I had several in the 118, 119 range. So love that about this racket. At net, it played super stable, and just all around, I love this play test. Nothing wrong about this racket.
Now that we've wrestled the racket out of Michelle's hands, we've got Mark Boone up. And you've been kind of gravitating towards the heavier rackets as well lately. I know adding some weight to yours. How did this one work out for you?
Well, as a mutual friend of ours once said, you know, you live the 12-ounce dream, can you live it forever? You know, I'm sitting right now playing with 11.9-ounce racket with a 320-ish swing weight. This thing is just over 12 ounces. I was able to live that dream very nicely. And like these guys alluded to, it is hard to find this racket, and I'm always, you know, well aware that it's going to be a very popular, fun-to-swing racket when you can't find it, so it was hard to locate. Anywhere from the court, this racket, I really like the 16-20 pattern. I've discovered more and more that I like that tighter pattern, particularly when the tension drops on the poly. I seem to get a really good ball pocket out of it. Felt a little slippery at first, but once the tension dropped on it, I thought I got great slice out of the stick on my backhand. Forehand topspin anywhere in the court, I really like this racket a lot. Given Michelle and Troy traditionally play with heavier rackets, I probably would be more effective with the 310. I'm more Mark the Boy instead of Stan the Man. But overall, it's just a great play test.
I was also on this play test. I was also on the play test of the previous version, and I definitely noticed a very subtle improvement to this one. Kind of like Troy alluded to, it's got that crisper, more responsive feel, left me feeling more connected to the ball as it left my strings and gave me that kind of magic wand feeling in my hand. I really enjoyed the feel of this racket, especially up at net, coupled with that heft that the racket offers. Felt super solid and stable. I felt like I could put the ball anywhere I wanted. But unlike the others, unfortunately, I kind of struggled from other areas of the court. I did like it off my backhand side, but on my forehand, I just wasn't quite getting enough spin to corral the extra power that I was getting from all that heft. On serve, I had a little bit of trouble getting it up over my head quickly to generate some good racket head speed, so I had trouble locating my targets consistently. And on the return of serve, when I took a compact swing and just redirected serves, it felt good. But whenever I took a bigger swing at the ball, I just found that tighter string pattern, that heavy weight, just didn't quite lend itself to much forgiveness. But love the feel of this racket. Wanted to like it a lot more than I did from every area of the court. But all in all, a really nice player style racket with great feel. For this playtest, we've got this racket strung up with Babolat RPM Blast at 53 pounds. If you want to learn more, be sure to come to tenniswarehouse.com.